Hello everyone and welcome back to Limpopo Conservation Park. And today we are going to add the aardvarks to the zoo. How exciting! Yes, again, every time we start a video, it's very exciting. So what are we gonna do? Well, we're gonna build a kind of realistic style aardvark habitat. I did my research this time and I googled a lot and I watched a lot of videos, and I came to the conclusion that aardvark habitats are usually very boring. So I'm trying to change that a little bit. So I'm starting off with some fencing, some viewing areas for the guests. So we will have glass, and of course, not everything will be glass. So we also have some wooden fences right over here. I'm using the new kind of pillars that are in the Africa pack. I didn't use them yet, so I wanted to use them. Checking the scale, very important with the archer. If you don't have the archer yet, make sure you download it from the workshop. It really helps you to build to scale, or you can just put a staff member there or whatever. And I just wanted to make sure that the guests were able to look over the fencing and see the animals, and the animals are still not able to jump, I think, because they can't escape this habitat. I cut out some of the fencing work because it's not very very interesting. And I finally found a way to use these pieces, because I don't use these pieces very often. But when I was researching, I found a lot of these rock formation inside the habitats. And I finally found a way to use them. I've seen some people using them as a cliff formation. So I thought maybe I can use it like as a rock formation, which is covering up the building. And I first wanted to use it as a fencing. You can see I'm experimenting a little bit. How am I gonna do this? Well, I think in the end it came out really, really well. I'm super happy with the result. I actually built this habitat in only two goes. I think I had quite some inspiration. I had my research done, and it was fun. I really had fun with this little build. Sometimes I have to go back into the game like 5-6 times because I don't know what to build. But this time it was not a problem at all. But it's still Saturday while I'm recording this, because I'm just lazy with editing. Instead of working ahead, I'm just a lazy guy. You know how that goes. More fencing. I cut that out, as you can see. Otherwise, would been a very long video, and we don't like that. No, it's around 20 minutes again. I think we did a good job. So the rock formation. See, experimenting a lot with these things, and made some variations in there, and some level differences. You can see after this, it looks quite boring, as you can see. And later on, I will go back into it. But it's already looking quite cool. The sunlight was a bit of a struggle in this build, because I built it in a kind of a weird spot. And there's a sunlight in the game sometimes. The shadow is a bit harsh, so I can't really see what I'm doing. So you will see me moving the time all the time. But in the end, it works. I got quite a few nice screenshots from it, which is very important, of course. And right now you're making doors, so some slide doors to open up the indoor area for the animals, so they can go and play outside. In the game, aardvarks do play all the time, but in real life I found these are real nocturnal animals, so they don't really move during the day. So I also make sure that during the nighttime it all looks fine. And also a indoor spot, which is which does have some lighting but no windows or whatsoever, so they might move during the day when they are indoors. Right here, a viewing spot for the indoor area for the guests. I think that's very important. I'm using the one-way glass pieces. I never use them. This episode is full of new pieces. So if you are here and enjoying the video, make sure you're subscribed to the channel. We are moving towards the 10,000 subscribers really fast at the moment, and I'm super excited about that. Again, I wasn't expecting it anymore to reach this year. I really hope we can do it. So if you're not subscribed yet, make sure you do. And I really appreciate that. And yeah, also, we just announced a new competition in the Discord. It's called Pimp My Habitat, and it's kind of a different way of the Shell Challenge. And yeah, if you want to join that, make sure you join our Discord channel. There is a link down in the description, and you can join the competition. You can win some Steam gift cards, which is really cool. You can buy your favorite game or DLC, who knows. So make sure you are joining. So yeah, finally the fencing is finished, and we're going to take a look at the rock formation again, making sure it looks a bit more interesting, make some variations in it, and then we are going to continue with the indoor part. Right now I'm making some sleeping quarters, making sure that the animals have a space that they it's like a private space for them, and they can separate the animals as well. There are only two animals in this habitat, so I made two sleeping things, as you can see. And again, some slide doors, some flooring in here. Yeah, I'm enjoying the mud pieces for this one. Yeah, looks already very nice, right? Yeah. So yeah, separation for the animals. I'm trying to put some more details into these little things. Yeah, just using some some wood pieces right over here, making some roof structures. Actually, here I will delete them again because I was too fast with making them. I can't see anything what I'm doing underneath. It's very annoying for the camera, as you can see. I'm putting these new camera pieces in, so I thought maybe the keepers are able to watch the animals while they are in these things. Yeah, I'm not sure how to call it. Maybe some private areas or I don't know, sleeping quarters. You can name it. Yeah, let me know down in the comments what it's named. But anyway, another rock formation. Ooh, yeah. I'm trying to make it a bit more interesting on the inside, and I'm using these rock pieces again, which I normally don't use, but finally I'm using them, and they are quite cool if you blend them together. I like them. You can make a lot of out of it, but I never really experimented with pieces, but it comes out really, really well. So I'm happy. I will definitely use it more often. You can see copying to the other side, and it looked much better. These rock formation that we already used on the outdoor area, putting them in. And we're gonna make a cool little indoor section for the aardvarks. Very underrated animal, I think, in the game. I saw all your comments, like, which animal do you want to add? I saw a lot of giraffe comments, but I also saw quite a bit of aardvarks. So when I saw that one, I was like, yeah, I can add those. I'm not really sure about giraffes yet. Not really sure if they fit into this. Into this theme, and I'm just not sure yet if I'm gonna add them. So the outdoor section, yeah, how to make it look interesting. That's very very difficult, because as I said, like, a realistic aardvark habitat doesn't have much. Usually some sand and logs, and that's it. And what you normally see in a zoo is that they just throw down one rock and some sand, and that's it. So I'm trying to make it look a bit more interesting, trying to put the what are they called again? I always forget those names, don't I? The items they can use. Yeah, enrichment items, there you go. Yeah, see these little foraging thing, trying to blend that in with the first with the terrain. Didn't look right, so I'm using these rock formations again to make sure it looks nice and it's blended in, and they have like a bit of a private spot that they can play, but still the guests can look around and see them and see what's going on with the animals. It looks nice, right? I'm covering up this little ugly wooden thing, and then it looks much better already. See the rocks, making sure it all looks nice. The little rock trick, it makes everything look so much better. And then a broken tree, which I'm not gonna use because it looks weird, and I think it will block the transversible area. for the animals. In the end, this habitat, the transversible area, is quite good. I will make sure I upload it to the Steam Workshop so you can download it again. I know a lot of people always really like that, so I will put a link down in the description to the Steam Workshop where you can download this habitat, and yeah, you can use it in your own zoo. And make sure you let me know if you used it, if you enjoyed it, and give it some love on the Steam Workshop so more people will actually see this habitat and they're like, oh, I can use that. It's very helpful because it already has some staff buildings in there. So it has the keeper hut, and it has the staff room itself. So you could just throw it down, hire some people, and it's all good. I think, I'm not sure about the terrain work, if it's all okay for the animals. You will have to check. So maybe it's not the perfect thing for a franchise zoo, but you can always make some alterations, to make it sure it fits into your franchise zoo. But right now we're doing some lighting. Ooh. If you do lighting, make sure you use some red lighting on the indoor parts, because that's what they normally use for the animals, for nocturnal animals, because it won't wake them up, but you can still see them, so the guest can see the animals walk around in their indoor areas. So now I'm gonna move on to the building. Not much interesting stuff going on here. Kind of the same roof as we did with the Fennec Fox habitat. It's kind of the same style of building that we are using here. Just a flat roof, some trims, some nice little details. Then we'll add some more details on the backstage area of this one. Just some little props, stuff like that. So it looks like it's used. We will finish off the entire area with some foliage. So we finally have an area that looks kind of finished, and I'm super happy with the result. So I'm gonna leave you guys with the rest of the speed build. We'll go on for 4 minutes, something like that, and then of course you will have some wonderful cinematic overviews of this habitat. So I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you hit the like button. If you haven't subscribed yet, make sure you do, so you won't miss out on anything new. And I'm gonna speak to you guys in the next one. Goodbye, you.